Hi everyone, this is Dr. Gaurav Gupta, your personal child specialist, and today I have a special guest with me, Dr. Poonam Gupta, who is an eye specialist practicing at Charak Clinics Mohali, and she specializes in dealing with kids because Charak Clinics has pediatrician in the form of me and eye specialist in the form of her. Hi Poonam.
Hi Gaurav, how are you? It's so hot today.
Right. So today we'll be talking about coincidentally a problem which many of the kids have in the hot dry weather, and that is about rubbing their eyes constantly. So do you see a lot of these kids, Poonam?
Yeah, right Gaurav. I get a lot of kids with eye allergies, rubbing eyes, red eyes, watery eyes. They start in the month of maybe March and April, and then they peak in May. So there's a lot of dry heat in this time. And kids, those who have other allergies, right, rhinitis, sneezing or skin allergies, they tend to have these eye allergies more.
Okay, so this is a form of eye allergy that we are talking about, right?
Yeah.
Why is it so common during these hot months?
I can talk about this area. One, the heat, and the other is we have a harvesting season this time. So crops
yes.
are being harvested a lot. And the tri-city Chandigarh is a very green city, which is good for, you know, having a fresh air. But sometimes it can cause a lot of allergies, especially the pollens. So the kids land up with eye allergies a lot. And the other factor, which, you know, I have observed in my patients is the allergies are increasing. One of the reasons that can be is exposure to screens. Screens can be like TV, iPad, laptops. And nowadays, smartphones, because the excessive exposure to these screens causes a lot of dryness in the eyes. So the tear film, which contains all the nutrition and the oxygen for eyes, that is either reduced or the quality goes down. So the kids react, the eyes react more to these elements, the change of season, the heat and everything.
Okay. So it's basically a combination of inherent dryness, because of all the screen time which kids have, and now maybe the exams also means they're studying a bit more, so usme bhi eye strain ho raha hai, and then in addition to that all the dryness and pollens and harvesting,
definitely.
Great. So can we prevent this from happening?
You can take some measures. Like one, obviously, if the kids agree to their parents and they reduce the screen times, especially the cell phones. I tell most of the parents not to give cell phones to the children, and reducing this other screen time to maybe 45 minutes to 1 hour. So that will help in reducing the symptoms. The second, the kids who are more prone to allergies, they should use goggles or shades. So that one, the sun will affect them less, and the other thing is the shades act as barriers. So the exposure to pollens and heat is less. And the third is if they develop some symptoms of itching, irritation, and watering, they should go to the eye specialist as soon as possible and not wait for the symptoms to worsen.
Okay. And anything to talk about in terms of air conditioning? Does it help? Does it hinder? Because sabke sab AC mein to rehte hain.
Mostly the kids, they sometimes do complain the AC ki hawa is, you know, bothering them, which I again feel is because of the dryness of the eyes. But I think in an air-conditioned air, the humidity also goes down to some extent and causes a little bit of dryness. So again, it boils down to the dry eyes, which make the eyes more exposed to the elements.
Chaliye, to ye to baat thi about prevention. Anything which they should not do if they're trying to prevent or they're trying to treat eye allergies, bachche ghar mein kya karna chahiye aur kya nahi karna chahiye agar hame isko karna hai?
Ghar mein the measures what they can do is they can do cold compresses. Cold compresses is like they can take some ice cubes into the hanky and keep on the eyes, or they can dip cotton in a cold water and keep on the eyes. A big no is splashing water in the eyes.
Okay.
No water should be splashed in the eyes, because that again leads to dryness or it harms the tear film of your eyes, and that can again increase the allergies. So giving cold compresses helps the eyes, and I mean the parents can see with what is affecting. If suppose playing in a dusty environment worsens the eyes, so they can reduce that, or applying any particular cream, using a particular soap worsens the symptoms, they should avoid that.
Okay. सो आंखों में पानी डालना नहीं है. कोल्ड कंप्रेस कैसे दिए जा सकते हैं, व्हाट इज द बेस्ट वे, स्पेशली बच्चों के अंदर कैसे करना चाहिए?
टेक एन आइस क्यूब, पुट इट इन अ हैंकी एंड गिव इट टू द चाइल्ड. Tell them to, you know, keep on pressing. Or you can dip cotton in the eye, in the cold water and keep it on the eyes. Or they can use, you know, those gel packs, freeze them in the freezer of the refrigerator and keep it on the eyes. Anything.
Lovely. So, abhi, you were also talking about activities. So, aisi kaun si activities hain jo hame bachchon mein is weather mein encourage karni chahiye aur kaun si discourage karni chahiye in relation to eye allergies?
Unless, you know, Gaurav, child has very severe eye allergy, I usually do not recommend stopping any activity. Because bachpan bachpan hai, they should not stop any activity. They can take measures. For example, you know, parents come to me, doctor, we stop the swimming of the child. What I tell them is, continue the swimming. Initially for 5-6 days, you can, you know, you can avoid it. In the meantime, the eye drops start acting. And when the child goes for swimming, I try to tell them not to remove the goggles, the swimming goggles, so that the pool water doesn't come in contact with the eyes and doesn't irritate the already allergic eye. I mean, rest of the sports, they should not be stopped. Parents should go more towards the treatment. Unless the child has very severe allergy, which is called VKC. In those cases, we generally tell the parents not to take the child out, or, you know, the child should not be exposed to dust and should avoid any physical activity. But those cases are very rare.
Generally, as we say, dusty games, cricket and soccer especially, it will come kar dein, but you say ki after 4-5 days, this really doesn't need to be done for most children.
I mean, they can resume their play. If it worsens a lot of redness, lot of itching, they can avoid. But in most cases, I have seen the child is all right. If the drops are going on, the treatment is going on, the child is happy playing, so let them play.
Okay, so is weather mein, is there any other cause of itching also in addition to allergies, jiski wajah se eyes mein redness ya itching ho sakti hai, which may be different from allergies?
You asked a very important question. Nowadays, I am getting a few patients of viral conjunctivitis, a viral infection in the eye, which some of the symptoms of both the eye allergies and viral conjunctivitis are same. The difference is viral conjunctivitis occurs mostly in one eye. It is more of irritation in the eye, while there is more of itching in the eye in eye allergies. Viral infection causes more of watering and a mild amount of discharge, while eye allergies cause more of redness and some amount of watering. So if a child has redness only in one eye, that means the chances of an eye allergy are very less, because in allergy, both the eyes are involved.
Very true.
And parents should go to the eye specialist as soon as possible, because the treatment for both is different.
So I think that is very important, that agar koi doubt ho to sabse pehli baat to humare ko eye specialist ko hi dikhana chahiye.
Most importantly, viral conjunctivitis will spread also. If they don't treat it, a lot of friends and, you know, family members will get it.
While in allergy, this won't be the case, right?
No, this won't be the case. Unless the whole family is prone to allergies.
Allergies, which of course is quite common also. But it won't spread from one person to other. It will happen just because they are allergies. Okay, so we are looking at now the treatment. Is there anything over the counter which parent can try apne aap before they actually come to an eye specialist? Especially agar shuruaat ke symptoms hai, like you are saying. Kuch ghar mein try kiya ja sakta hai, some eye drops which are available without any prescription.
You know, Gaurav, normally I don't recommend over the counter treatments, because the basic thing is, first, parents need to confirm what is the diagnosis.
Okay.
Right. And in India, most over the counter treatments are either they are strong astringent type eye drops which sting a lot, or parents end up buying steroid eye drops, which is not over the counter, but in India mein mil jata hai.
Yes.
So I would say, get your diagnosis confirmed first. But if you're not able to go to the eye specialist, what you can do is apply cold compresses, and if there is any good lubricating eye drop lying in your house,
okay,
which are just extra tears, you can put those in the eyes. They will give some relief. They will not treat the eye allergy, but they will give some relief. Suppose if their parents are not able to take the child in a couple of days to the eye specialist.
So how do these tears substitute, jo hai, jinke bare mein bata rahe hain, how do they help in eye allergy?
They will reduce the dryness, which is one of the factors which worsens eye allergies. So it will help in some extent. In fact, nowadays the studies say for a faster relief in the treatment of eye allergy, we should add a lubricating eye drop.
Lovely. But that is, I think, a very important point, which not only the parents, but maybe if some eye specialist or child specialist doctor is listening to this podcast at some point of time, they can also benefit from this. So at the end, I would just like to know if there is anything else that you would like to talk about in terms of pediatric eye allergies, which our listeners can benefit from.
One, this allergy, what parents normally get frustrated is the allergy keeps on occurring. They either in the change of season or during summers only. Sometimes what they do is after a couple of years, they just give up. Ki ye to hona hi hai.
Bilkul theek hai.
So what they don't realize, it's the child who's suffering. The itching, the irritation, the watering. Kids somehow are very adjustable and resilient. They keep on, coping. But the parents need to understand allergies as such, be it eye or any other allergy, cannot be cured from the root. We can control it. So as long as the child is having allergy, he or she has to be checked.
So, इसी से दो चीजें आई मेरे दिमाग में. एक तो ये है कि one thing which I tell for as a pediatrician for allergies related to the nose and chest is that in children, if you start aggressive treatment, अगर आप अच्छे से इलाज करते हो, you can definitely reduce the incidence of allergies in the future. चाहे वो cure हो या ना हो, but definitely severity तो कम हो जाती है, which is a good thing.
Definitely, you're right. बहुत कम हो जाता है, even the episodes decrease.
And the second thing is about preventive eye drops or eye care. जब आपको पहले ही मालूम है कि होने वाला है, तो for example for nose and chest, we always say कि अभी season आ रहा है, तो उससे पहले ही आप अपने nasal sprays या inhaler शुरू कर दो. So I guess something similar could be done for eyes allergy also if you know कि कब allergy शुरू होती है.
Yeah, there are preventive eye drops. I tell few parents because in cases where I know the child is going to have allergies again in the month of say March, April or September, October. So I tell them to start these eye drops a month before. A few parents do that. A lot of them forget.
I agree. Itna kuch chal raha hota hai as a parent hamari life mein that sometimes ye cheezein yaad nahi rehti.
And incidentally, that is the time for exams. So eye drops to bhooli jaate na.
हाँ नहीं, मार्च अप्रैल में तो पेरेंट्स अपना खाना पीना भी भूल जाते हैं एंड बच्चों का सोना भूल जाते हैं. सो आई गेस या दैट्स आई थिंक दैट्स अ रैप ऑन दिस एपिसोड. इट्स रियली रियली इंटरेस्टिंग टू नो कितनी सारी चीजें हमें नई जानने को मिली हैं. एंड आई एम श्योर सो मेनी ऑफ आवर लिसनर्स एंड पीपल हु आर इनफैक्ट लेटर ऑन वॉचिंग दिस मे बी ऑन यूट्यूब एज वेल, दे विल बेनिफिट फ्रॉम दिस. थैंक्स अगेन पूनम फॉर बीइंग ऑन द शो.
यू मोस्ट वेलकम एंड इट वाज अ प्लेजर टॉकिंग टू यू.
Lovely. So till the next time, we will have more special guests and we'll have more sessions from Dr. Poonam definitely, because she is really a specialist in children eye care in addition to whatever she does with all the adults. The kids are really happy with her also. So we'll definitely have her for more sessions. And till the next time, till we meet again, thank you, take care, and hope all the kids that are under your care also do well. Bye-bye.